What's up guys, Sean Nalawani, seannal.com, realscienceathletics.com, and in this video today, I want to give you what I think is the simplest and probably the most accurate method to calculate maintenance calories for a beginner. So if you're looking to build muscle with a focused bulking phase or lose fat with a cutting phase, then regardless of what anyone tries to tell you, on the nutritional side of things, managing your net energy balance, so your total calories in versus your total calories out, is the most important baseline factor in your entire diet. And it's the underlying foundation that everything else gets built upon. You know, your macronutrient breakdown, your food selection, your meal timing, your supplements, all of that comes after you figured out how many calories you need to be consuming per day based on your goal. And figuring out your calorie maintenance level, so how many calories you need to consume per day to maintain your current weight, that's the very first step in the process, so that you can then add the necessary calorie surplus on top of it for bulking or the calorie deficit needed to stimulate fat loss. Now, the normal route that most people go when they're trying to figure out their maintenance calories is they use a calorie calculator. There's a bunch of different ones out there, the Harris-Benedict formula, the Catch-McArdle formula, there's basic bodyweight multipliers, and all those methods can have their place and they can work fine for a lot of people, especially if you are in within at least a moderate body fat percentage and your activity level is somewhere around average. I've used calculators personally and I've recommended them to others as well to use as a basic starting point. But the downside is that depending on the person and depending on certain factors involved, sometimes they can be fairly inaccurate. And that's because, well, for starters, differences in body fat percentage are gonna have an impact on your resting metabolic rate, because the more lean mass you carry, the more calories you're gonna burn. And calculating your body fat percentage itself is also really difficult to do accurately. And then on top of that, the type of lifestyle that you lead in terms of how active your job is or how much you walk per day, that can easily add up to several hundred or a thousand calories or more per day in terms of your total expenditure. And then also the activity multipliers that the calculators use are also just rough estimates as well. And they're kind of subjective too, because different people are gonna have different ideas in terms of what it means to be lightly active or moderately active or highly active, and that's going to affect the results even further. Now, this other very simple method that I want to give you is also not perfect, because no method for calculating calorie maintenance level is, but assuming your body weight has been at least somewhat stable over the previous week or two and it hasn't been significantly increasing or decreasing, then instead of using a preset calorie calculator and then adjusting your food intake to that number, what you wanna do is the opposite. So start with what you're eating right now, figure out how many calories that represents, and then use that as your estimated calorie maintenance figure. Because if your body weight has been reasonably consistent and your overall activity level hasn't been significantly fluctuating from week to week, then whatever daily amount of food you're eating right now is what you require to maintain your current weight. The maintenance calories are all there right in front of you, and all you need to do is just go ahead and add them up. So what you wanna do is manually log your diet for about a week or so. Just eat how you normally would. Use a nutrition tracking app, or you can even just log things manually. Make sure to take into account every food, every snack and every drink item that goes into your mouth without skipping over anything. Then find out what the daily average is and then use that as your estimated calorie maintenance level. And then from there, either apply your calorie surplus for bulking or your calorie deficit for cutting, and then just use that as your starting point for your bulking or cutting phase. Again, this isn't gonna be perfect, but if you add things up properly, then it's most likely gonna be more accurate than using a preset calculator. And you can check out two previous videos that I did, the links are in the description box, where I discuss how to track your progress and how to adjust your calories during your bulking or cutting phase, depending on how your body weight is changing from week to week. Remember that no matter what calorie calculation method you use, it should always just be treated as an estimated starting point, and you're still going to need to go ahead and track your body weight closely and then adjust things if it's going up too quickly or going down too slowly. And just as a final point here as well, if your body weight has been kind of all over the place lately, or your food intake is really inconsistent from day to day, or your activity level has been significantly fluctuating and you're really just not sure how to go about calculating how many calories you have been eating on average, then in that case, yeah, using a preset calorie maintenance calculator is fine. And a few methods you can use are to either multiply your body weight in pounds by between 14 to 16, going with the lower or higher end, depending on how active you are. Or you can use the Harris-Benedict formula, which I'll link in the description box below for you to check out. Or if you do have a fairly close idea as to what your current body fat percentage is, then you can use the Catch-McArdle formula, which I'll also post down below as well. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope this advice was helpful. If you do want to get a complete step-by-step roadmap when it comes to all aspects of proper nutrition for building muscle and losing fat, along with fully structured training and supplementation plans as well, then you can grab my complete body transformation blueprint program by clicking up at the top of the screen or visiting btblueprint.com. For those who are new to the channel, my brand new science-based pre-workout fish oil and multivitamin are also now available over on realscienceathletics.com. The link is in the description box. And make sure to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe below if you haven't already in order to stay up to date on future videos. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.